Now, a Champions League standard all-weather sports pitch has been opened at a school in Yeovil today. England and Southampton old boy Matt Le Tissier officially opened the pitch this evening.
As part of a £1 million investment in grassroots sport, it's been part-funded by the Football Association. They hope that the investment will produce some key sports stars of the future. Simon Lewis reports.
A field fit for champions. This all-weather pitch at Butler's Mead School in Yeovil is part of a £1 million investment. And its aim? To produce sports stars of the future.
We knew we were getting a good pitch. I don't think we realised quite what a good pitch we were getting. We were told just last week that it's one of the best 120 all-weather pitches in Europe. In fact, so good that potentially it's the sort of standard that European Champions League games could be played on. I'm not sure we will get Barcelona or Real Madrid here, but it's nice that our pupils at Butler's Mead can play on a facility of that quality.
It's really good to play on. It's a lot safer and it helps to get your ability stronger because it's such a good surface to play on.
It encourages you to make you run faster and you play all around better sport. I think the whole school in general feels very pleased that it's here.
As well as impressing the students, the school is also hoping the new facilities will strike a chord with the Ofsted inspectors. In their recent inspection, the school was described as having many outstanding features, a standard which they want to maintain and improve.
One player already playing Premiership football, we've had other players play at lesser levels, and I would have thought with these sorts of facilities then maybe more and more Butler's Mead pupils will be representing Premiership clubs and maybe even England one day.
Facilities like
now that she's back in the atmosphere with drops of Jupiter in her head.
So, do you ask any teachers for us?
She acts like summer and walks like rain. Reminds me that there's a time to change. Since the return of her stay on the moon, she listens like spring and she talks like June.
Obviously, after 14 years of being head, you've called it a day. If I last 14 years in this job, I think I'll be exactly the same as you, looking to to get out while you still can. Obviously, you're a Southampton fan, and they turned us over a couple of times last year. We'll be playing in pre-season, so we'll try and get our own back on them. But just wish you well for the future. Hope everything goes okay, and well done for a great job that you've done with the school. Cheers, mate. Bye.
Hi Mike, or Mr Featherstone as I should be calling you, Andy Lindegaard here. Apologies that I can't be with you today to share with you your final day at Butler's Mead School. But here's a video message just to wish you congratulations on your retirement and best wishes for the future.
Hi Mike, Mike Crane here, Coventry and obviously Southampton. Just wanted to wish you a happy and restful retirement and I hope you enjoy the free time you now have. I wish you all the best for the future. Take care.
Hi Mike, my Packer here, Butler's Mead, England rugby player. Just want to congratulate you on your retirement and all the best to your future. And thank you very much for my 5-6 years here. Enjoyed it. Thank you very much.
Hi, Matt Letizia here. Mike, congratulations on your retirement this year. Hope you have a restful but productive life after school. At least now you've got a bit more time to go and watch the Super Saints. Good luck and best wishes, Mike.
Hi, Mike. I've been asked to say a few words from the grave because I'm probably one of your biggest influences in sport. I want to take you back to 1975 on a glorious day at Cheltenham when I was running in the Gold Cup. There was a corruptible young man who innocently turned up to watch me run this very famous race. Of course, do you know where it is yet? With me. The Dickler. You know, I won the Gold Cup and the George the King Six twice, and obviously the Gold Cup in 1975. I knew he won a bit of money maybe that day as well. Now that probably had a bigger effect on you than you knew at the time. You know that's why you've not bought a car for the last 25 years. Well, Mike, congratulations on your retirement and best wishes for the future. The Dickler.